Hello and welcome to this follow-up video. In my previous video, I showed you how to make a GPS data logger for under 7.5 euros. With this logger, you can easily display your flight on Google Earth. I will put a link to this video in the description. Now, this video was primarily intended for GPS devices that have easy accessible I/O pins like this one. In the comment, people asked if this data logger could be used with a GPS of a DJI Naza. And that was an interesting question, if I may say so. The GPS of a DJI Naza uses a ubx-GPS module that outputs the raw GPS data. So in theory, it should be possible to tap into that data and log it onto the SD card. Now, before continuing, I must inform you that this modification will void the warranty of your product, and you are following these instructions at your own risk. So please think twice before you crack open your GPS module. To open the GPS, I use a T5 Torx screwdriver. Be very careful and don't use excessive force. These are tiny screws that you can easily strip. And if you do, you need to drill them out. And this is how the inside of a Naza GPS looks. As you can see, they removed the type identification sticker of the ubx module and placed some Kapton tape over it. I have an older version of the Naza. I think one of the first that came out. But thanks to Vortex on rcgroups.com, we can see that the basic layout of the various types and versions of the GPS module is almost the same. The next thing that I did is to look for the data that we want to write to the SD card. For probing, it is best to use a scope. Now, I know that not everybody owns a scope, so I show you an alternative method of probing. Take a piece of wire and connect a 1K resistor. Use some shrink tube to isolate it and cut off the excessive length. Connect the wire to the RX port of the FTDI breakout board like this. Open UCenter from ubx and select the correct port. If you don't have UCenter installed, I recommend you watch the previous video on how to install it. Now select the baud rate of 57.6 kilobits per second and open the binary console, so we can see if there's any data coming through. For safety, disconnect the motors or ESCs and power the Naza. Now you can carefully probe the ubx GPS module and look for the correct output pin. To prevent magic smoke, it is best to use a sharp probe that you connect to the 1K resistor. This makes probing much easier. Also note that there is a thin protection coating on the board, so you might need to wiggle your probe to get a better connection. Now, don't probe the pin that is connected to the antenna. There is a big chance that you destroy the ubx module if you do. At a certain point, you will see this on your UCenter screen. It's a message that has structure in it. Not very readable, but you see that the UCenter accepts this as a valid data stream. If you have any GPS reception, you might even see that the clock starts running. This is not NMEA data. DJI, in this case, uses the UBX data protocol. Chris from iForce2D did a great video on this UBX protocol. I will put a link to this video in the description so you can learn more about this UBX data protocol. But this is the data that we need to write to the SD card. In my case, this particular signal is routed to this testbed, which has the marking GT or GPS transmit on it. And as you can see on these pictures, this testbed is available on other Naza and Phantom GPS boards. Now, a small testbed like this is not a very reliable connection. So I strongly recommend to make a connection to this point where the signal is routed to the other board that has more strength in it. Take the wire with the 1K resistor and carefully solder the resistor onto this connection. The 1K resistor will prevent the GPS onboard data signal to get corrupted. So make sure you use one. Route the wire on the outside of the board to minimize interference with the antenna signal. And that's it. It's time to carefully close the GPS and place it back on the multicopter. Don't tighten the screws all the way, so there's a little gap for the wire to come out. The other side of the wire is connected to the RX pin of the data logger. To power the logger, you can use the 5V from the Naza if there is a spare connection available. If we probe the signal on the data logger, we can see that there is a very nice 3.3V data signal. I took this quad for a flight and it behaved like it always does. There was no signs of interference whatsoever. To finish this video, I will show you a 2.5 minute hover so you can see that the GPS functions without any glitches. Thank you for watching and see you next time.